Hello, Barbiethon viewers. Are you ready for Barbie and the 12 Dancing Princesses, the best speedrun in the Barbie series?
Bold claim. I think we are ready.
Okay, am I good to go then?
Yeah, whenever you want, just count down time and I will try to sync it up. Click here to start a new
adventure. Okie dokie. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Let's start the adventure. Okay, y'all, welcome to Barbie and the 12 Dancing Princesses. The game has already crashed on the very opening frame. That is not what we want to see there. How does it even do that? Zuko's gonna be so disappointed in me. Okay, I'm ending. That's gonna be a little bit of time loss. How did it crash?
Well, I restarted the timer, so just just go again.
Go again, awesome.
Never happened.
There we go.
That's hilarious.
Like, not even half a second in and it's crashed. Okay.
Yeah, just instantly crashed.
You want to try this again?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, go. Start the adventure. Okay, that's a little more like it. Okay, welcome to Barbie and the 12 Dancing Princesses, with hopefully a little bit better of a start here. So this is the PC version of the game, which is, like, actually very different from the Game Boy Advance version, and it is better. 3D. I think this game was made like along with the movie, and I don't know if they got like all of the information, just a bunch of sprites, because it doesn't really align with the plot of the movie. But the general plot of the movie is the dad is sick because the evil stepmom is poisoning him, and you gotta go get the elixir to save him. So first section is this apple section, and this is actually like the biggest RNG in the game. We just got perfect RNG. I'm not kidding, you can be here for 15 minutes, and so that, like, flute there can spawn- Oh, of course I messed it up. Yeah, you know, I got perfect RNG, then messed it up. Zuko's probably cracking up right now. This is, like, this is fantastic, but all in all, this is a pretty good start to the apple section. And then the first real skip that I found in this game is called the celebration skip. So basically, once you finish any game, any minigame, the character will do a little celebration there, and you can actually just exit out of the minigame and skip it as if it was a skip cutscene. And I think the reason that works is the game just like checks it for completion, and then you can quit out and it'll still make everything else load outside of the minigame. So kind of there's just this like tutorial section before you get to the real game, and you do 3 minigames, and there's just a few like platforming between them. The second minigame here we like to call Birds. And Bird's gonna have a little bit of RNG, not as bad as the apple one, but it can still get pretty scary at times, and you're just feeding each one of these 4 birds twice. The one complication here is there's these leaves that can get in the way and slow you down a very good bit. So far this is actually going pretty well. What you want is for like the leaves to be going down as the bird pops up, because that means you can feed it right away. And you don't want to have any miss inputs like I just did there, and went to the right when I needed to go left, so I had to wait for the leaf to go back down. And then right here I'll also have to wait for it to go down a little bit too. Let's see, and then see, I'm gonna have to wait for this one. All in all, not the worst birds in the world. We'll take it. And then we can do another celebration skip right here. Right as Barbie puts her basket of apples down, you can exit, and then you go back in here and you skip a little celebration there. So it's a little sad we don't get to see the happy Barbie celebration with her claps, but we do save some time, and that's generally what we want to achieve in a speedrun. So that's Birds out of the way, and up next there's just a castle puzzle. This one's just like a little jigsaw puzzle you get to do here. And it's pretty cool because you can click fast and get the puzzle really quickly, but it can also go wrong. This platforming section, it takes a little bit, it's kind of sad, you gotta wait for all these rocks to go up. Let's hurry and... But yeah, rocks are going up and down, and it makes a very annoying noise. Like, if your volume's too loud, the noise of those rocks going up and down is pretty gross, and it's like, it doesn't make sense, because the rocks are just floating. You don't know why they would be making such a grinding noise, but now that we're done with that, we'll just continue following Twilight at the end here, and right here, I'll do a little time save that saves a second. I don't think anyone else goes for this, but, oh, it's in a little bit. you just take a line to the left, and if you get stuck on like a random out of bounds plane, it can like lose 3 seconds, so that's probably why it's not the best trick to go for, but it's kind of just a little meme strat here. So we'll see how this goes. It's kind of fun. So you go past this first section here, and then right here you can go here, you can jump, and then you get to take this line across here out of bounds. So normally there'd be a wall there, but I don't know if it even saves that much time, but it's pretty cool. So now we're gonna go grab this key right here, or the coin, and then we do this puzzle. So this is a little jigsaw puzzle we could do. It's pretty fun, pretty easy. So you just put each one of these things right in their spot. Oh. Sometimes the hitboxes on these things get annoying. And you can immediately quit after this. I missed the... So first, after this, we're gonna go east. So there are 11 princesses we have to get, and then the 12th is our gate to go through, which is Genevieve's, the main character we're playing as. And basically, when I first started running this, I think I copied who had world record at the time and just did them in order of north, west, south, east, because east is the last one. But Zuko and I have come up with this strategy as to just maximize the hardest ones first, and then like you do the easiest ones last. So we're starting off with this one, which there's some history behind this gate right here, which is the lily pad section. So on, I don't know how this worked before, but on the PC version we're playing it as, there's a little bit of a trick jump there, but the lily pad section does not work if you are on an FPS of higher than 200, or like 220. So that's why I'm playing it as 215, to get as high FPS as possible without being over 220. And if you're on 220, it immediately soft locks. So we have to lock the FPS to any number lower than 220 to be able to actually play that section. And so we just played it as the first section because sometimes it can mess up, and in general, it's not the easiest of sections either to play. So that's the first one we've done. And when we were first testing that, it was good to have it first because you weren't sure about the soft lock of it happening or not, but we've got it to happening almost never with the FPS limiter, which is awesome. But no, there were even like forums of people saying the game is unbeatable because of it, so we found a way to achieve success on this section. So here's the lily pads. You basically have to hit each pad before it gets to the left here, and if you miss one, it can lose a significant portion of time, so it's usually good to hit all of these, and we got them all, so that's pretty good. Saving time there. That is what we want to see. Now we gotta give the oh, I missed gems there. See, this is what I was saying before, is so the princesses can be different, and you have to assign each princess their gem, and it's a little section there, but generally I'm pretty good at it, but I messed one up there. But honestly, it doesn't lose too much time. It shouldn't matter too much here. Ah, missed that. So right here, we have a little dance section. So you pick 6 dance moves for the princess to do, and then it's about 50 seconds of dancing right here. So if there's anything that Soul wants to say, it's kind of just a 50-second dance move here.
Well, hey, you know, we don't have anything particularly time-sensitive or pertinent to say, but I do want to say, this run is really impressive so far. I haven't watched too many runs of this game or anything in detail, but you're doing really well. So great job.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, for sure. And also, we should have everybody put something in chat. What do you want everybody to type in chat?
I can't think of anything right now, but I'll try to think of something before the next dance section.
Awesome, yeah, and then the next time you can tell everybody.
Okay, I had forgot which way to go there, but we're going east for Princess 11. This one right here is probably the hardest platforming in the game. So once we get over there, I'll show you. I guess it's hardest when you do a skip. You can jump straight over to one of the crystals and then do quick jumps on 2 other crystals, and it would save about 10 seconds. I don't think anyone has actually pulled off an optimal crystal jumps here inside of a run. Or I might have before, I think I have, but Generally, I think everyone goes for pretty safe strats here, and I've done some riskier ones during runs, but here I'll just go for a very safe strat, which would lose about 10 seconds to optimally, but if you fall off and hit the water here, it's a pretty tough respawn, so that's why it's risky to go for some scary jumps. So it's coming up right here. These are very easy jumps, and then, let's see, right up past this, you'll be able to get a glimpse of it. Up ahead, if you can see those moving crystals. So generally, we'll jump across this one over to the purple, and then wait for the green one to go down. And then, if you're fast enough, you can jump all the way up to that orange right there. But for here, I'm just going to play it safe and not try to go ahead, because sometimes if you stub your toe, you can fall off the ledge, and that'll lose lots of time. Not what you want to see. So that was pretty safe. Nothing went wrong. Always good to see. And then we just go up here, and we get to play the minigame. So this minigame is pretty fun. You're just going across as the cat in a circle, and you got to grab 8 flowers. Sometimes the timing here can get annoying, and if you hit one of the rocks, you lose a flower, and you kind of get stopped for a second, so it's actually pretty bad if you miss a flower or hit a rock here. Ooh, I was really close to hitting that stump. But no, I think we'll get out of here just fine. Awesome, that was a very good kitty catch there. And give the gem to the princess, and we're back to another dance section.
What a choice! What a choice! This dance star show will look beautiful! This is going
to... Okay, there's our...
I really want to hear, like, giant swing back.
You know, so some of the dance, they resemble Fortnite dances, and I don't know if that was, like, intentional, but, like, I think Fortnite probably copied Barbie and the 12 Dancing Princesses.
So. I think so, you know. I do remember, because the other day, Zuko was channel, like, playing PS3 and I do remember noting that, like, the dance moves are weirdly modern for the vaguely historical fantasy set of the game. Like, yes. What is this, you know? Why is this happening?
I know, it's like some very interpretive dances.
Yeah. It's very of its time. You can tell this game is from the 2000s.
Now, oh god, I'm missing the directions. After 2 misdirections, I think I'm only about, like, 26 seconds behind PB right now, which I guess isn't too bad for 10 minutes into the run. Okay, so up next is the west side. So this side is kind of infamous for a lot of difficult parkour jumps here, like that one that I just missed. And then, so for each of these sections here, you gotta grab a key as you go, and for the ones on the east side, the key wasn't too difficult to grab, but for here, sometimes you gotta remember to go off your path a little bit to grab the key, and missing that can lose a good amount of time. So right here, there are these things spinning, and what you're supposed to do is jump to the platform. Well, you can actually skip it by jumping like this. And there, I got it right there. So you don't have to wait for it to spin all the way for the platform with the edge you can jump on, but we'll see how this goes. I've already missed that jump right there. I think if I'm fast enough, I can still make the first cycle here, but we shall see. So right here, I made that jump there, so we should be okay. There's a little cycle at the end with a platform that goes all the way across and back to get you up on this area. And if you get a second cycle there, it is... Actually, that's not great. There's actually a considerable amount of time loss. So hopefully we can get there on the first cycle, but we shall see. So here is the platform you get to. And yes, we did get it on its first cycle, so that's pretty awesome. And then we go up here, and this jump here, yeah, we missed that. That jump can be a little annoying, because the platform will float up and down. A little sad to miss that jump, because it's pretty easy, but coming up is Dance Dance Revolution Barbie Style, so... Hope y'all like this. It is very easy, but some very nice Dance Dance Revolution action. So much fun. You just basically use the arrow keys and hit it once it goes into the spot. And the voice acting behind it, it's pretty nice, very motivating. Keep dancing, have to find the elixir. And yeah, as you can hear, they're saying, we have to find the elixir if we're gonna save Father, because we gotta find that elixir. And I think for my first time running the game, I didn't actually pay attention to the story, so I was just like, what is this elixir? And then I ended up watching the movie that the game was made along, and I found out more about the wonderful plot behind Barbie and the 12 Dancing Princesses. So we do another.
I do like the implication that, you know, your first time they were just dancing, and you're suddenly it's like, yeah, keep dancing, yeah, dancing, and then we have to find the elixir to save Father. Yeah. It's like, wait, hold the hell up.
I know, I'm like, so what is this elixir, and why do we need it? Like.
While dancing.
Oh man, I don't know what the dancing has to do with acquiring the elixir, because like all we do for the elixir at the end is just go grab it, but I don't know, the dancing, it's very helpful towards getting it. They had to somehow incorporate it as the dancing princesses, not just any
Normal
princesses.
12 princesses, nah, 12 dancing princesses.
Well, so up next is Princess 5, which has the infamous yellow jump, so we'll see how that goes. That's a fun one indeed. I like these dances, like the one with just like the arms going over the head, the little shimmy, like they're very...
Yeah, it's cute.
Okay, there we go. I went the right direction this time, so that's good. Let's see if I can get the key properly. One of the important, I guess, time savers in this game is basically whenever you enter an area, it'll pause and do a little, like, talk about that area, and if you just press escape, it'll skip the talk, and then you can start moving. So, usually I'm just, like, spamming escape the entire time, because it also kind of stops the voice actings. And one thing I've also forgot, I can't believe I forgot to mention this the entire game, and we're 16 minutes in, haven't talked about Brutus. So Brutus is the pet monkey of the evil stepmom, and the entire time, Brutus is stopping you by coming down and grabbing these gems that are floating everywhere. The gems don't actually have any purpose throughout the game. You can just grab them, it doesn't count the gems, and it doesn't tell you how many you got. So they're just like, kind of for fun. Oh yeah, here's yellow jump. So the jump actually isn't that hard, it's just if you miss that jump, you're being respawned terribly far back, so it's killed a few runs in the past. So I missed the jump, but I got a respawn on the ledge there, so it didn't end up losing too much time. I think probably like a 2 second time loss. So here we just have a little bit of parkour to do. It's kind of just a run to the next minigame, which is the Rainbow Cloud Catch minigame. Oh no, that was a very easy jump to miss. Actually put us on a slower cycle. But yeah, Rainbow Cloud Catch is a very fun one. There's a little area off to the left there. I went and explored it. I think it's literally just gems to grab, so I don't know kind of why they added that, but I guess it's fun. So there's a first view of the rainbow here for the Rainbow Cloud Catch. This is... Now we just gotta go up these steps and then go grab the coin to get put into the minigame here. Oh, we got a little bit of a boost there. That's nice. Okay, so here's the Rainbow Cloud Catch. How this game works is you're basically grabbing the gems to create the rainbow, but you can't hit any of the rainy clouds, or if you hit 3 rainy clouds, it'll restart you, so that's generally not what you want to do here. But you just grab these gems, and I think a gem comes every 4 rainy clouds. Yeah, this game, or this minigame specifically, was geniusly programmed. Like, a lot went into making this, but it is very fun. So, we just got 2 more now. We gotta get blue and violet, and then we will have completed the entire rainbow. You sure? Let's see. Oh, and they have a very pink looking violet, but the green princess here. Oh no. So, some struggles. Hey, back to our dance section. I guess if anyone in the chat wants to answer what their favorite princess they've seen so far is, that is for dance. Nice dancing. Thank you, Zuko. I know, dancing here is like phenomenal.
Truly top tier set.
Zuko, do you have a favorite princess? Also, I like the music in the background here, like some nice jazz.
Oh yeah. It's like I could plausibly see but I will tell you what I was gonna say is that when I clicked onto the stream to listen to the music that was playing in the background, my brain immediately thought Seinfeld theme song. So anyway.
Okay, so we have one more gym to get in the west area here, and then we'll be on to the north. And so the reason we do north next is there is a skip on Princess 1 in the north called Princess 1 Early Cycle. And that isn't even, like, it is just the left princess, but the reason I call it Princess 1 is because it was the first one we did originally, so it's just been coined that name. But this section is generally pretty easy. There's one little hard part at the end that could get messed up, but in general, this is the easiest of the West princesses. So right here, we just walk across here. There's not even any platforming to do. It's just, the spinning is completely a distraction to get you scared, but yeah. And here, we'll jump over and go across the bridge, and then there's another platform to land on. You know, this game really loves its floating platforms. Like, I don't think I've ever seen a game with so many floating platforms.
And that's one thing that I noticed too, is like, because of the way the respawn system works in this game, the floating platforms are kind of the only, like, obstacle that matters. Because since you can't respawn on the moving platforms, it's like, oh, move this way, but if you fall, you're gonna respawn way back there. And that's kind of all it throws at you.
Mm-hmm. So right here, you have some floating platforms, and these cycles, if you miss a cycle, you can end up losing a lot of time because of the way they, both of them will go, or only one of them will switch, but then I think this one's actually pretty consistent. There's a one at the very end where if you miss the cycle, you're losing 40 seconds. I guess depending on if you can get a really lucky hit or not, but we figured out a way to hit the cycle every time if you get there without losing any time, which is cool. So right here, you're supposed to put in different dots to, like, make fireworks, but making fireworks is time-consuming in a speedrun, so unfortunately we get a very sad fireworks show here with zero fireworks. So sorry for all the fireworks enjoyers in the chat. This one is that. There we go. We get another dance section here. So, the East and the West are the most time-consuming princesses. The North and South are both actually a lot shorter, so I don't know why they made just like different lengths, but I guess kind of the sub-theme of each area is pretty cool. Like, the first one had, or the West one had all the, like, floating platforms. The East was, like, the water. Now, you'll see the North is all about this fountain, so it's a pretty cool-looking area. Yeah, I might actually be saving time here. Yeah, I like some of the songs are different. I like that one there. It's very chillax and cool. Let's wait. Another misdirection. Coming up is North Princess 1. So, the infamous Princess 1 early cycle. You'll see it here. So I guess first, this little platform is kind of precise. You need to get there fast enough where it'll start going up. So you grab the coin, jump on the platform. If you're too slow, it'll start going up and then you can miss getting up there. And then right here, we just gotta wait for this platform to come across. And we have some lily pads. So lily pad physics in this game can be very weird. Generally, you want to land on the lily pad, stay on it for about half a second, and then jump off. There, it looks easy, but like, they can get really funky. And right here is the Princess 1 early cycle. So for whatever reason, when you land on this platform and immediately jump, it starts going up a little bit earlier. You jump early, get on the lily pads, and then jump off to the right. That was... Oh no, and then I stubbed my toe and missed the early cycle. So that basically ends all chances of this run getting anywhere close to world record, because it's another 10 second time loss there. You have to wait for the lily, for the platform to come all the way back. But it is all right. So this section is a little fun. You're just, I don't even know what this is supposed to represent, but you have a bubble and you're moving this little spiky thing to get the sprites, as they call it. I really, you know, and my theory about that is like, sprite is generally what you would call like, just a drawing of a a computer character that would move. So it's like a sprite. Like, what if maybe they just like did the voice acting there and then didn't fill something in, so they ended up saying sprite, because it looks like a balloon. I don't know. What are your thoughts on this soul closet?
I think like, because they've got like music notes in them, and they kind of look like what am I trying to say? Christmas ornaments.
Christmas ornaments, yeah.
They kind of look like Christmas ornaments. They kind of look like bubbles. You're in the water. The spike is nondescript, but the bubble is definitely a bubble. Yeah. So I feel like they could plausibly be like magic bubbles. But a sprite, when it's not like a computer image, is like a fairy, right? So like, there's no way that these are fairies because you're killing them.
Yeah, I don't know. They're...
And so, yeah, I feel like you're right, if anything. Like... They probably were just like, ah, yeah, you have to grab these sprites. And then they never changed it. Good choice. You're going to make a
so,
which is just great. The mark of quality.
I haven't actually done any research into this, but I do think that this game was made along with the movie, because a lot of it just has, like, they keep saying the same plot as the basic synopsis of the movie, but, like, nothing else more in detail, and all of the stuff that goes on in this game has nothing to do with the plot of the movie, other than the fact that you need to save Father and get the elixir. So,
oh, so you think they didn't have like the movie as a reference while they're
making the game? But I need to look into that, because like I'm just like, it's complete theory.
Yeah, would be interested. I wonder if you could go through the credits and like find people's work history on LinkedIn or something, where you can see like when they were working on this game.
Now we go north. Oh my goodness gracious, yeah. I need to work on those directions. So, Princess 2 here, this one in general is pretty easy, but there's one little jump here that can be optimized a bit. So we go right here, we take a very tight line for time save, and we jump across, we grab the key, and then jump off. And that was pretty poorly executed, but the jump off there, this is one of the times we use respawns to actually help us, because you have to go out of the way to grab the key, and then you can jump off into the water, respawn well, and then jump across, which is faster than turning all the way around there. Keep going. We're doing so well. We'll find the elixir in no time. And now we just run up here and play another Dance Dance Revolution section. This is another thing that shows that... Oh, this isn't a Dance Dance Revolution. I'm sorry, guys. I lied. The next one is Dance Dance Revolution. But this one is a little fountain show. It's another one like the fireworks, where you're supposed to fill in things to make the fountain... do different... I don't even know what it's supposed to do. I haven't seen it. I know the fireworks show, but like, the fountain does different things, I guess, but we don't do that in the speedrun. We just press star and check it right away. Okay. Back to another dance section. We have to actually watch through 11 of these throughout the speedrun. or 12 actually, because you, your character does one at the very end. And it takes up, I think, a whole like 9 minutes in total. This is some nice music here, very techno jazz. They have, I think, like 3 different songs this cycle here, it's cool. But one thing I do have to say is I don't think the game like was fully completed, because there are mini games that they will play through twice. Like the Dance Dance Revolution game, you end up playing that 3 times throughout the game. It's like, you think they, if they wanted to make a full game, they'd make 12 different mini games, but no, they only have like 7, and then there's just 2 that get cycled. Oh, they have the like shows. They'll have the fire. Oh, it's the wrong direction. Oh, no. This path will take us to Ballet Beauty. Uh-oh, we need to get going. See, there's an example of the lily pads being annoying. So yeah, those lily pads are actually kind of obnoxious and can lose time.
The water terraces are beautiful. Hey,
which led to us losing a decent bit here because we missed this cycle. That's unfortunate. Well, so coming up after this, we're gonna have another Dance Dance Revolution section, and in here you can actually save a little bit to doing some optimized parkour jumps, so I'll see how that goes. Just jump across here, and then we go grab the coin in here. Actually, there's no coin. I lie. Oh yeah, we go in here to grab the coin. So we can jump across this rock. That's a little bit of a time save. We got it there. Uh-oh. Oh, okay, so another fun feature of this game. If you jump while in any of the stairs inside of the minigames, you'll just fall through the floor. Yeah. Don't know how optimized this game was. So yeah, the Dance Dance Revolution is, they had to make this good difficulty for 6 and 7 year olds, and it just ended up becoming very easy, but that's okay. You know, they're like, yeah, let's make it on both sides, that'll make it difficult, but there's only ever 2 notes on the screen at one time, so.
Can you imagine this format of minigame, but like a really, really hard arrow chart?
I don't know, like,
as a step minigame thing.
Hard mode, there's like 17 notes per second.
I would love that. I would play the hell out of that.
Okay, so that's done with our north section, and now we just have the south section and the last one left. And so the last one is the very middle of the east, but you can't actually get there until you've finished all 11 other sections, so 3 more to go after this, and then we can finally go get to that one. And that's the longest one out of all of them. It is, like, even in the speedrun, you take 8 minutes to finish it just because there's so much content, and it has what is the hardest parkour jump in the game. It is a big boy jump, but I guess we'll get to that once we get there. Coined by Sean. I think right now we are on pace for a 51, so that would be nice. We'll see how everything else can go.
Yeah, you've been killing this so far. I mean, like, there have been a couple small things, but it seems like you've been pretty much nailing it.
So now we're gonna go do the south section. This section, in general, is an auto-scroller, but there are a few things that can go wrong. So first, we'll just go grab the key. And then go run to the area for this one here. Once we found all the princesses, you just kind of like run and jump across these, and this is I think the longest out of the 3 in south section. I guess you've got a little bit of a trick at the end, but it was a little hard early on, but I think in general, it's very easy. So it's a little maze, but not too difficult of a maze. And then we just jump across these platforms. Walk onto Yeah, so this camera angle, not too great, because we want to stand on the corner there to get off quickly. And then we're just going to run across here, and we got to go get the coin. Honestly, I'm not sure why the peacock is there. I don't think there was a peacock in the movie, so I guess they just had, like, an extra peacock character model, and they're like, yeah, let's throw it in. Go for it. Let me just go across here, grab the coin, and we do another Dance Dance Revolution section. See? I'll warn you, they don't get any more difficult.
Alright, dancing is so much fun. Keep dancing. We have to find the elixir. We have to keep on dancing if we're going to save Father.
This game is reused 3 times, and it's just like the same exact thing with a different princess, so it would have been nicer if they could have made more games that would have made for a more interesting game, but I guess the DDR, it's fun. All the kids like it.
We have to find the elixir. Kids love dance games. Barbie and the 12 dancing mini games, I guess.
There we go.
Hey, dance star with a princess. Great choice! A perfect dance move! This dance star show will look beautiful! Good choice!
Okie dokie, so coming up now, we'll have Princess 8. And Princess 8 and 9 are both two of the shorter ones. I think 8 is a little bit shorter than 9, and these are usually just quick and easy to go through. So, almost done with the dance section with, you know, I remember, so like all the princesses have names from the movie, but no way am I remembering all 11 names, but... And it's very interesting, the way the movie did their characters, each one had, like, a very specific thing they liked, so that was pretty cool.
Let's head for the...
Well, so...
This archway...
Who knows, now we're just gonna go north here. This one, I guess, the one thing that can go wrong here is you could miss the key. It's a little bit hidden off to the right.
Let's keep going.
And by hidden, I mean like 2 feet off the path, but
this path will take us
right here. This one is very short. You just go do some parkour jumps, press some buttons, and then you go activate the fireworks scene. Or this one is a, I don't even know, I think it's a light show. So
we need to find the elixir. If we're
just press these buttons, and you can immediately press escape after you hit on the button to get the cutscene. I thought I missed that button there, but I guess I did end up just getting like an instant escape. No, I did miss the button, huh? I have not seen that before. That was interesting. Huh. Well, there's a little bit of time loss there. Didn't know it was possible to lose time. Well, lose time here, but I ended up doing it.
All right. To stop the show.
So yeah, it's a little light show that happens. I don't know why they call it a light show, because it looks like just magic sparkles, but I guess during the lights they'll have like lights going here and here, but we don't have time to make that happen, so we miss out on that. Now Is Princess Nine our last princess put in? There we go.
Good choice. That sure is a pretty. The dance star show will look beautiful. This is going to be.
Oh, here's the extra special song here. It's very out there. I don't know how you would describe this genre of music.
As much as I may regret saying this on the stream, I think you can only call this penis music.
Seems like an accurate description.
Yeah.
So yeah, the dance sections, as you go on, the 55 seconds seems to, it does feel like it takes forever, but, you know, I think the little kids, they love enjoying these long dance sections. But here we go, into Princess Nine. So this one, you play a little hide and seek, and you've got a little bit of parkour inside of it, so that's fun. But right here, you can take a little bit of a shorter line. Get to the silver key, and then you grab the key, and that's really, this one is honestly pretty easy. I remember when I first, my first run of this game was like a blind run. I just like hadn't played it before, and I got to here and just like couldn't figure out how to beat it. Because of the way it does it, it puts you back into where you could get to the maze section, and so I just like got back to that section, and then got so confused. But like the parkour here, I guess once you actually know how to do it, is pretty easy. But I could imagine a child having trouble figuring out how to solve this, as I did. So what you do here, oh, there's our peacock friend again, is you just go right here and you jump across. But if you fall off, it just puts you back in the maze. So see, I thought right here is finding Twyla. Twyla's actually in the same spot every time here, or it's same spot in every game. It is right, left, left. So we can immediately tap on the right one to find Twyla, so it's not much of a hide and seek inside of the speedrun as it is just remembering which one to click on right away. And then right here we can immediately do a celebration skip. There we go, our second to last dance section here. This is going to be a way to go! A fantastic dance move! Great choice! Back to the very funky music. Okie dokie. So far this is going pretty well. Here's our final section, which is the longest one, and it's probably got... So I said the hardest parkour was in the west, but like that was, I guess, outside of this one. The final one is kind of separate from all the others, and inside of this, you've got... I guess the biggest skip is BBJ, but a few like minor jumps you can get along the way. And I did theorize a trick that could be done there, but I don't think it's technically possible unless you have already completed it and gotten a checkpoint somewhere else. But I could show where that is near the end. So to get to the final east section, we just go back into the east and then we go to the very middle one. And I'd say this area is actually kind of hard to navigate for someone who doesn't know where to go. Just a lot of bridges and islands.
We have to find the vial of elixir. There's so many.
So we just go across here, and then when we go here, we just go straight to the right, and we get to the final section here at the end. We get a little crystal bridge that comes up to await our arrival at the elixir. So I guess right here you can do a little bit of a time save by jumping onto the bridge early, so it takes a while to raise up, and then right as you see some land, you can jump. So now that there's land, you can jump across, come over here and get the key, and we're well on our way to getting the elixir. So in here, this is actually a pretty easy section, but very punishing. So there are these platforms, and you gotta walk across the platform, but as you can see what happened there, sometimes the game will just like break a little bit and you'll stop in your tracks. If that can happen when you're walking from one platform to another, you can fall off, hit the water, and the nearest respawn point is back to the land, so that can lose a lot of time very late in the run, but generally it's pretty easy. And you just want to like walk onto the platforms right as you get to the end. So we should be good through that. This area right here is important because there are going to be some platforms later on, and if we lose any time here, we will get a very slow cycle on these platforms, so it's actually important that we get fast cycles here. I think that should be good enough. And we go across here. Yes, we got the fast cycle there, so that's awesome. To help Genevieve get to the... And coming up here is going to be Big Boy Jump. So, Big Boy Jump was, we originally thought it was impossible, and it was kind of just a meme to go for this jump. Because I thought it could be possible and explained it, but like, in general it was just like too hard. And then Sean went for it as a joke in one of his runs and actually hit the jump. And he ended up saving 20 there, so what's gonna happen here is there's this spinny thing, and right as you go across this platform, you're trying to get onto the spin thing. So here, I'll explain it as far as I go for it, because... So you jump across and try to land on that blue thing. So what it does is it spins to the right and to the left, and we're trying to get over to the left there where those platforms are. If we can jump onto the platform right there, get onto it early, see I missed it. What we can do is run across to the other side and get to the platform, and it saves about 20 seconds, but the normal cycle there, as you saw. Oh no, that's not good. Well, the normal cycle would be to get off on the light blue right there, but I missed the jump. So now we've got some platforms to do here. I hate these platforms. Right here, you actually, if you jump over on the top platform up there, you can glitch through and go to the fall to the bottom platform again. And I've done that on a few runs, and it's a little obnoxious to do that. So if you're doing that motion, you can clip through it. I don't think- oh god. So see, as you saw there, it started to clip. It's a very unfortunate thing to happen 46 minutes into a 55 minute speed run. There we go. I guess that doesn't even lose that much because we ended up getting a fast cycle here, so that's alright. So normally that cycle there is a lot slower. But I think with Big Boy Jump, you save even more time because you would get to that cycle earlier. But we're in the home stretch here. We just gotta go across a few waterfalls, and then we are almost to the elixir. I'd estimate right now we're on pace for about probably a 52 or a really high 51, but that is still ahead of the estimate of 55, so that's awesome. Pretty happy with that. So you know, as Soul, they did make this joke earlier. I think I will make one joke about it. One common critique of Barbie's hair here is it does kind of look like a penis. So I don't know, the game designers, what they were really thinking with that.
Yeah, it kind of does. I mean, penis music is like an established joke. I don't know if you're familiar. I didn't make that up. I can't take credit for it. But you are right.
I've heard of that before.
Yeah, it's stuff that sounds like that song we were listening to. If you look it up, I promise you shouldn't find anything bad, and it'll instead just be funny music like that. But yeah, no, you're right. That is some interesting hair.
Okay, so right here, this is where I actually theorized a skip to do with respawns, where if you could get a respawn landing you back where the other button was, because you're gonna have to run back there in the end to get the elixir anyways, but in the end it didn't end up working. And I've also thought if you can jump to that platform you would save time, but neither Zuko, Sean, nor I have ever been able to make it back to there, so unfortunate. So now we just ride these platforms back to the other side, and then we can go run up to grab the elixir. We actually have to hit all four of those buttons, or you won't have a crystal up here at the top to be able to jump over and get the elixir. So it's a little unfortunate that you have to press all of the buttons, because it does lose a lot of time going to get all of them. But I don't think there is a way to skip them, unfortunately. Oh my goodness gracious, are you kidding me? So there's a little demonstration of terrible respawns throughout the speedrun. So I stubbed my toe right on the edge there, and it respawned me back all the way over there. And I guess that actually kind of showed kind of how the trick works. So if you have already gone back and hit that respawn where I stubbed my toe, you technically could... the only respawn where you would have next is where it just respawned me, and if you can skip hitting something that would respawn you right there, you can die and then respawn right here, which would save a lot of time. But of course, no, I just did the reverse of that, which is dying and getting respawned way over there back by the platform. But it is all right. We will still finish under the 55-minute estimate.
We need to get to the top of these crystals.
There it is. This is the magical elixir. So now that we've acquired the elixir, we just put in the final gem. And we have one last dance section, now, with you, the character, Genevieve. This is one of the biggest twists in gaming. So, yeah, pretty exciting to see you, the character, having your own dance section. And then, after this, just the final fountain, and you do a show there, and then the run is over, so... no more real gameplay, you just have to watch this last dance section. And yes, unfortunately, I think we are getting a 52-something here. I didn't actually look at what the time was. So, we'll see, it'll be somewhere in the mid-52s. Okay, so timer will end in 20 seconds now. We just have to wait for this whole fireworks show. Well, actually, there are no fireworks because we just skipped making the fireworks, but that's okay. I think it actually combines the lights, the fireworks, and the fountain show at the end for a finale with all three. And time. So, oh, that ended up being a low 52. Wow.
Yeah, 52.05.
Let's go.
That was really great. Honestly, that was really fun to watch. I hope everybody at home enjoyed it too. You guys should all go follow SpyTex. Twitch name is SuperSpyTex. It's on the screen and linked in our schedule, which you can get to with exclamation point schedule. Did you have anything else you wanted to say or anybody you wanted to shout out before we go?
No. Thank you so much, though, for the opportunity to play through Barbie and show it to y'all. It was really great. I hope y'all liked the speedrun. It's very fun.
Yeah. No, it was a great time. I'm glad we got to show this off. Next up on the stream is going to be Zuko Block. So, again, my wonderful co-organizer Zuko has done 7 different runs for you guys. All pre-recorded, but all back-to-back-to-back. And we'll be airing that starting not too long from now. So sit tight and get ready for a showcase of a lot of the more...
me?
Hi, Cam.
You want to go for a ride?
Sure, Cam.
Jump in.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life in plastic, it's fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation.
Come on, Barbie, let's go party.